Hello students, welcome back. Today we are going to discuss about streaking or streak plate. Okay, a method which is used widely for getting isolated colonies. Okay, so when you get a sample, say unknown or known, to know its colony morphology and proceed for isolation, we need a pure culture or isolated colony. And for that, we use streak plate. Okay, so let's start. So what is a colony or colony formation? So what does that mean? So we know that we cannot see bacterial cells by our naked eyes. We need microscope. But when these bacteria, they get nutrient supply and proper moisture and other condition growths in lab, when all these requirements are provided in lab, means on a media plate when they are placed, they start growing and they multiply as million and millions of cells, okay, and that forms a colony, and that is what we observe on our media plate. Okay, so all these cells in a colony, they have same characteristics. Why? Because starting from one bacterial cell, that cell divides into two daughter cells, and those daughter cells further divides, they multiply a lot and lot and lot to form a colony. Okay, and that's why all these cells, they had originated from a single mother cell, they all have same characteristics. Okay, a colony is defined as a visible mass of microorganisms all originating from a single mother cell. Okay, so that's how you see an isolated colony. Okay, the bacterial multiplication, it results into colony formation. Okay, so that was the basic. Now, colonies formed by same microbial species growing on same media will all look alike, right? Why? Because the cell shape, then pigmentation, then division plane, rate of cell division, and other characteristics of organism result in progeny. Progeny means a daughter cells which stack on one another in a pattern resulting like a characteristic colony form. Okay, what happens as the cell multiplies? What happens? Cells, same daughter cells, they get stacked upon each other, and that results into a colony. Okay, so let's learn how streaking is used to get isolated colonies. Okay, so first we will see what is the main thing in this method, how this happens or how we get isolated colonies. So for example, let's suppose you get a swab sample from your dog, and how will you proceed to get isolated colonies? That's what we will study. So this actually depends on when you transfer your sample by using wire loop or swab to sterile media plate, the cell, it gets transferred or deposited and they start growing. Okay, so the medium of carrying that particular bacterial cell is your wire loop or swab. Okay, so this is simple, right? So this is how a zigzag inoculation pattern looks. Okay, so generally for swab, this zigzag inoculation pattern is used. Okay, so let's see example, like you take a swab sample of your normal doorknob. Okay, then as the swab moves across, now what you will do, you will use that particular swab, it is a sample, now you will use that for inoculation in a zigzag pattern. So as the swab moves across the agar, leaving cells, how leaving cells? Cells from swab are getting transferred, they are getting deposited onto agar plate. Okay, in a zigzag pattern as shown in figure, regions which are touched later in the process will have fewer and fewer cells. Okay, so you started from this point. Okay, this is the first streak. Okay, so this will be the region which will have higher growth or aggregated colonies. Okay, and as you move further, what happens? As all the cells are getting deposited, your number of colonies will get reduced, as the number of cells which are transferred, they also get diluted. Okay, so that is the reason you get isolated colonies towards the end point. Okay, so this is the actual plate. There is very minimum isolation. Still the colonies are well crowded, but still, for example, I had uploaded this picture. So when you swab a door handle where bacteria are likely to be present and then press the swab across the surface of nutrient agar, cells would be deposited onto the surface from swab. Okay, initially starting zone will have fairly high concentration of cell and the area touched by it will have lots of different types. Okay, why different types of cells? Because you got a sample from your doorknob. Okay, so don't know how many people have touched that particular doorknob and it is open to air, it is in contact with air, so dust particles will settle and whatnot. So that particular doorknob will have different kinds of bacteria present on it. Okay, so after this, these grow up, these cells, progeny, that means daughter cells, they will start forming a colony and will crowd together. Okay, and overlap with the other cells' progeny, forming areas called confluent growth. So confluent growth is what? Where many colonies are growing together. Okay, so in this particular case, there are three types of colonies. So for example, I have shown three, but on doorknob you get a lot and lot of different kinds of bacteria. Okay, so one is brown, one is gray, one is off-white. Okay, so they all start growing together and that particular zone is known as confluent growth. Okay, and what is isolated colony? Individual cells which are far enough apart that each one would grow into a discrete colony. A discrete isolated colony is this one. Okay, so a separate individual colony is known as isolated colony. Because the door handle likely has variety of microbes in it, there are different colony forms and this technique is called zigzag streak and is one type of isolation streak method. Okay, so I use this particular method to describe you, to explain actually what happens when you use swab or a loop to transfer your media, transfer your culture, how bacteria they get deposited or transferred to your culture media and how you get isolated colony. Now moving towards wire loop and swab. So this is a metal nichrome wire loop. So that is reusable. You can heat that particular wire loop many times and you can use that. This particular one is plastic wire loop and that is use and throw. Okay, so you get this these loops are available on many company websites. You can order or you can purchase online and all these are sterile. Okay, they come into individual packets. So once you open one single wire loop packet, you have to use that and you have to throw it away. You cannot reuse that. Okay, and this is a cotton swab. Okay, so you have a swab and the outer one, the container is there to carry your sample till your lab or your working place, right? So this depends where you have liquid cultures or in lab generally when you are dealing with cultures, directly with cultures or enriched broth, there you use wire loop. But when you have to swab something, say a table surface, doorknob or some other surface, you use cotton swab. You cannot use wire loop there. Okay, so depending on your sample, the use of cotton swab or wire loop will depend. Now let's move towards other streaking methods. So T-streak and quadrant streak. Okay, so mostly in institutes, these two techniques are taught and they are highly used in practicals as well. So the T-streak and quadrant streak are forms of dilutions on a solid surface. So in these two techniques, the plate is divided into sections, means quadrants. Okay, so bacteria are deposited in the first section at full strength from the source. Means this is the first zone of your inoculation where the bacterial count or bacterial population is high. Okay, so then after inoculation of first quadrant, what you do, you sterilize your loop. So from this point, no additional cells are added to your agar surface. So when you flame your loop, you ensure that it is cooled enough or it has very low temperature, so it does not kill the bacteria from this particular zone. When you carry this particular or we can say when you get inoculation carried forward from this particular quadrant. Okay, so this is the second streak or second quadrant. Okay, so why we did that? Because your loop had some bacteria present on it, and this is the highly populated area of microbes, okay, or inoculation zone. So you don't want to carry that much population ahead. What you did, you flame incinerated your loop, and now just take one or two streaks from first quadrant and carry forward, okay, streak again. The sterile loop is used to spread out cells that have already been placed on the plate. That means from the first zone, we used the inoculation to spread out the cells. After spreading cells from the first area to the second, again the loop is sterilized. Okay, this eliminates extra cells from your loop. Okay, the sterile loop is used to spread some cells from the second area into the third area, diluting them further. Okay, so again from this particular quadrant, second quadrant, we got inoculation. We took our bacterial population further. We inoculated that in third quadrant and we move ahead. Okay, so this was our third quadrant. Okay, so in case of T streak, there you will observe three quadrants, but in case of quadrant streak, you observe four quadrants. Okay, so this depends on the technique which you are using. So let's see first T streak or three quadrant technique. So what you do, you turn your plate, divide it into three parts like shown in here. Then you label your plate properly and you start streaking. So what you will do in the first area or first zone, you will inoculate your culture and you will streak ahead. So this is your first quadrant. Then flame your loop, let it cool down, and now you take some bacterial population ahead. You carry that population ahead and you streak for second quadrant. Again, you flame your loop, let it cool down, and you carry some of the microbial population to third quadrant and you streak ahead. So that is what you observe after incubation. See, first zone, second zone, third zone, or first quadrant, second quadrant, and third quadrant. So what happened? The bacterial population was high here. This is the confluent zone. Okay, and then we got two to three streaks from this particular quadrant. We carried it over over the other part, and this is our second quadrant. Again, we flame incinerated our loop, and we carried the microbial population towards the third zone or third quadrant. And what is the observation? Your bacterial population got diluted, and you got isolated colonies even in your third quadrant. Okay, so this is T streak or three quadrant technique. Next is four quadrant technique. So here you can see, this is the first zone of inoculation or first quadrant. This is second, this is third, and this is fourth. So on incubation, you will see results somewhat like this. You will get isolation in fourth, or sometimes if your microbial population, initial microbial population, is so low that you may get your isolated colonies in third quadrant as well. Okay, so this also depends on your initial microbial population, right? Then this one is example for zigzag streaking. Okay, as we use swab for zigzag streaking, even you can use this technique for wire loop streaking also. Okay, so on incubation, you will see results like this. So this is one more diagram to show you how how you get the growth. Okay, so first you start from this point. Okay, you apply loop full of culture. So this is the heavy confluent growth. Then again you apply flame loop and you streak second quadrant, you get heavy growth. Again the bacterial population gets diluted, you get light growth, and then you get discrete colonies, means isolated colonies. Okay, so for those who are very new to this technique, and if you don't see where your streak line is I would suggest that please tilt your colony light, tilt your plate little bit, and against light you will see your streaking lines. Okay, so don't mix up the fourth quadrant with first quadrant. Okay, and if you mix up here, you will not get your isolated colonies. Okay, you will ruin your plate, you will ruin your streaking, and you will not get isolation at all. Okay, so what are all these steps you need to follow, and how to do streaking in aseptic techniques by following aseptic techniques? That is all I am going to discuss in second part. So that is just related to the procedure. Okay, so very quick and short video for streaking, so you can watch that on my channel. So let's begin with the rest of the part. So after all the regions have been inoculated, the hope is that you will get isolation in the last section or the last quadrant, as cells are far enough apart so that they will grow into isolated colonies. Correct? That is our motto. We are diluting the microbial population from first quadrant to second to third and then to fourth. Okay, so we are likely to get isolation in fourth colony, and it also depends on your sample. If your sample is having low population, then you may get colonies, isolated colonies in third quadrant as well. So this technique allows one to observe isolated colonies and characterize them and determine if your observations are consistent with your expectations for the organism you are working with. That means if you know that your culture is pure, or you are just working or dealing with one particular culture, then you should get one type of colony on your plate. But if you are having unknown sample or you have a mixed culture, then you will get different types of colonies. Again, depending on your colony, whether it is growing on your streak line or it is not growing on your streak line at all, you can determine whether that particular colony is from your sample or it is contamination. Okay, so if you are working with pure culture, you would get you would expect that all colonies would look the same. They will have similar size, then the color will be similar and shape will also be similar. Okay, so always for writing colony morphology, you should be looking for fully grown isolated colony. Okay, so compare all the colonies from the isolation zone and select that particular colony which is fully grown. So maximum size, the colony which has maximum size, that one colony you should pick for writing your colony morphology. And if you don't know about colony morphology, or you want to clear your concept for colony morphology or colony characteristics, then the video is already uploaded on my channel. You can check it out. Again, for gram staining, I would like to recommend. So the viva question and the concept for gram staining is also there on my channel. You can check it out. Okay, so if you are getting different looking colonies, then that indicates that your culture has been contaminated or you created contamination by poor aseptic techniques. Okay, so we will be discussing aseptic techniques in part 2, so don't forget to watch that part. Then in between flame sterilization of loop, is it necessary or it depends on what? So it depends on your sample. Okay, so suppose you are working with an any sample, medical related sample, where you need to isolate all the possible microbes present in the sample, then you should not flame sterilize your loop after streaking each quadrant. Okay, so say you have a sputum sample given, and you need to diagnose that why the particular patient is suffering from this and this disease, then you need to grow, or you need to have all the possibilities of growing all the possible microbes on your plate. Okay, so you will just sterilize your flame at the beginning before transferring the sample. Okay, and once you take a loop full of culture or a loop full of sample, then you will not flame sterilize your loop in between any single quadrant. Okay, by transferring the culture, you will complete your streaking, and then once you complete your streaking, close your plate, keep it aside, and properly incinerate your loop so that you will not pass on any contamination. Okay, so this is about bad isolation. So what is the problem here? So the problem is actually the first and second quadrant. The isolation part or the used media part is very high, that there is no space left for third quadrant. Okay, so that is the reason the all three zones are showing very crowded or confluent growth. Okay, so very bad isolation plate. So these are other techniques or other methods used for streaking, and one can use any method, but be sure that you get isolation. You should be confident enough that by using this particular technique I can get isolation. Okay, and if you are new for streaking, then I will say that practice makes man perfect, and this is the very basic skill for a microbiologist to have. Okay, so practice and practice a lot, that in one go you should get isolation. Okay, so this was all about streaking or streak plate. So thank you for watching my video, and do like, share and subscribe to my channel, and recommend my videos to your friends as well. If you want videos on some other topics, then do mention that in comment box, or you can reach me out on my Gmail ID, and that is mentioned in my description box. Okay, so thank you for watching. Keep supporting. Thank you.